Hey, everybody. Halloween is approaching. I was going to do a little project for my grandkids. I have these pieces of wood. They're shaped like a pumpkin. Kind of. I was going to use my wood burning kit. And wood burn some jack-o'-lantern features into the wood. Then I was going to stain it. And on the back, I was probably going to put their names on it. And with any luck, someday they'll be old, and they'll still have them. And they'll still remember that I did these for them. Of course, I'll be long gone. But that's okay. That's how it works. Always has. Always will. I debated on painting the pumpkins orange instead of staining. But ultimately I decided I would stain them. But when I was thinking about painting them, I was kind of looking around the studio at things that were orange, like a pumpkin. And of course my Duncan Imperial yo-yo is orange. I've had a lot of fun with this yo-yo over the years. I'm not a yo-yo master, but I still have fun with it. I had some other things laying around that were orange. I have some orange pens. Here's a ballpoint pen from the 1972. Here's a fountain pen. This is from 1926. That's right. 1926. At the time of this video. This pen is almost 100 years old. Here's a matching pencil from the same era. It's pretty shades of orange. I had some other things within arm's reach of my desk here. It's got a little bit of orange in it, this quartz owl. I think you've seen this in a video before. But an owl has kind of a Halloween feel to it. He's got some, he has a chipped ear. He's got some big eyes. This skull isn't orange, but it does have a Halloween feel to it, and it was within arm's reach. I suppose I could make it orange by adding this Cleveland Browns helmet to it. There. He's ready for the big Halloween game. You don't like the Browns. Maybe you like the Cincinnati Bengals. These little gumball football helmets are from the 70s, I guess. Here's another Cleveland Browns. It's a little bit lighter shade of orange than this one. But yeah, that's very, very Halloween-y. What about this Porsche 997? This is a slot car. See, there's the flag. That's what goes inside the slot on the track. But it's all orange. And it is seen plenty of time on the track. It's got a nice rumble to it. This car, it's nice and orange. It's a lot, quite a bit smaller. But of course, now they look like they're the same size. Large, small, large, small. This is a 1970 Plymouth Roadrunner. Back in the day, I hate to say it, but I used to do some street drag racing. There was a guy that had one of these. I still remember his name. It was Julian. Yeah, that's right, Julian. That car was so fast. So fast. During that particular time, I had a Trans Am, but I also had one of these. This is a 1972 Ford Gran Torino Sport. Mine was a 73. This one here is a 72. The difference is 72 had a non-functional head scoop in the front end, looked like this, which is slightly different than a 73. I always loved the lines of that car, the back end. It's a fastback. It's beautiful. The designers did a great job on this car. I got the ride in one of the 72s when it was brand new. It was green. And the laser stripe on the side. And it looked exactly like the car in that Clint Eastwood movie, Gran Torino. Here's another orange car, kind of keeping with that Halloween theme. This is a 1970 Buick GSX. GSX. It's a pretty sweet ride. The cars looked so good back then. Here's a 1971 Plymouth Challenger. Nice, pretty orange car. 426 Hemi. Shaker style hood scoop. Nice spoiler on the back of the trunk lid. Very nice. Here's another orange car. 1979 Ford Mustang. It's a Cobra Mustang. I used to have an 81. The body style on this generation of Mustang was known as a Fox body. My 81 had a T-tops. Used to love to drive that car on a nice summer night, Saturday night, T-tops out. We took the T-tops out, put them in their special cases, put them in the trunk. My Mustang was all black. Here's another orange car. It's a 70, I think. Challenger. It doesn't say on the bottom. But I think it's a 70. Pretty sure it's a 70. Convertible. 426. And this car has just as much white as it does orange. But it does have black. Also, orange and black are Halloween colors, and all of these cars are pretty much orange and black. This is a Hot Wheels. What do they call this? Midnight Auto, O-T-T-O. Midnight Auto. Some good looking cars. Nice thumbnail for the video, especially if I put the Porsche in the background. Maybe a little football helmet. Some other things that are orange as well. What about Hulk Hogan's skin? It's kind of an orange tint to it. It's like some of those tanning products that you just rub on to get a tan. I don't know if that's what this is, but it could be. Kind of had an orange tint to it. Or maybe this Viewmaster is red, but the handle is orange. In case you don't know what a Viewmaster is, you have these discs with pictures on them. This particular one is from a TV show called Full House. This was something left over from my kids. They grew up, moved out of the house like kids tend to do. They left behind some things. I've got quite a few discs and a couple of these viewers. In this little window, you can read what the scene is about. What's that say? She will be my new mommy, says Michelle. Got some other things that are orange. This rail car is known as an auto loader made by a trailer train. This is a Tyco rail car from the 70s. But there was an orange car on here. This rail car, there are AMC Javelins on top, Chevrolet Camaros on the bottom. This is a Camaro. It's quite a bit smaller than these cars. unless you do some trickery with a camera. Yeah, I like this. Now they look the same size. Now they don't. And now they do. Yeah, I had a Tyco train set when I was a kid. I still have the locomotive and the caboose. A few of the cars. Here's my box of not 8, not 24, not 32, but the Smack Daddy 64. I never had these when I was a kid. My parents never would get me that set of 64. Some of the kids in class had the big set like this. I didn't. I told my wife about it. And she made sure that I got them. There's orange. There's a few other shades of orange. This is yellow orange. So orange, yellow orange. Salmon. Macaroni and cheese is what they call this one. Scarlet. Red, orange, yeah, there's plenty of orange in this box. Most of you know that I like fountain pens. And with fountain pens, you can use your own variety of ink colors. This Noodler's Dragon's Napalm. This picture of this dragon had a lot of orange in it. look at that? Would you look at that? That's beautiful. I bet the people of Tennessee would think so also. Tennessee defeated Alabama last night, yesterday, in a football game. I think they said it was the first time in 16 years. They definitely earned and deserved the win. Now this ink isn't orange, but it's very Halloween-y. It's got a, I'm not sure if you can see it. It's Noodler's Widowmaker. It's got a Black Widow spider as the artwork. Very spooky, very creepy. You don't have to shake fountain pen ink, but I do, because I like the sound. Just like blood. It is actually blood red. Maybe that's a little too graphic. I think that pretty much does it for the things that are orange that were within arm's reach. Now the cars were not in orange reach, arm's reach. I had to get those another display case. But I just noticed these scissors. Nice orange handle. So I hope you like this video. Here in just a minute, I'm going to get the wood-burning kit out and wood-burn the jack-o'-lanterns like I mentioned a few minutes ago. Where'd they go? I stacked a bunch of stuff up on top of them. Yeah, so I'm going to do some wood burning here in just a few minutes. And I'll probably release the video that you're watching now within a few days, and probably release this one a day or two before Halloween. I wonder if I can get it all in one shot. They say that a good video thumbnail draws in viewers. And we want viewers, there's no doubt about that. I could put this 1926 pencil right here. Maybe orange crayons right here. You're probably asleep right now, but if you're not, let me know in the comments by using the phrase now, just by using the word orange in your comment. Yeah. Here we go. I didn't get it all in the picture, but I got enough. I appreciate you watching. And we'll see you in the next video where we would burn the jack-o'-lanterns. Take care.